When I became an adolescent that couldn't care less about testosterone in my taste for film, like most boys did, I would be reaching for those high-end musicals that could sweep me away into a world that was jolly and beautiful. My nan gave me a copy of Singing in the Rain one Christmas and became a catastrophic attack. That DVD was watched 100+ times, with no joke included. So began my further research into all of MGM's classics, but mainly Gene Kelly's filmography. A singer, dancer, actor of tremendous talent that has inspired many decades later. It's been 10 years and I still haven't gotten through every single film. Late last year, I encountered a VHS tape of Brigadoon, this big hit of a musical by Alan J. Lerner, serving some iconic classics you might know. A movie that's been around, yet barely noticed. I figured it'd be some war musical as the DVD cover didn't tell me anything, but here it seemed outlandish and whimsical. When I watched it, the songs glued into my head, the dances put me into a dream, and there's this one scene in particular that took me aback. To get to this, I'm going to input a decent amount of context if you haven't seen it before. Roaming through the outer wilds of Scotland, two Americans, Tommy and Jeff, go hunting. On their ventures, a village called Brigadoon is lively and gay that resorts themselves to a ye old lifestyle. There's merriment for a wedding, Tommy falls in love with Fiona, one of the main ladies to pluck the heartstrings in a single day, even though he is engaged. Jeff is left with Meg, a woman who swoons at his sight, and trouble is afoot as Harry, whom loves the bride Jean, is in such high disagreement he tries to leave Brigadoon. Excusing the cookie cutter romance it takes within the one day, the songs are of an earworm quality. Hearing the marching bounce of Go Home with Bonnie Jean keeps clicking in my head. Heather on the Hill remains as mellow as the beautiful hills that are danced upon. And I almost love, almost like being in love. The choreography explodes, and the performances are graceful in how they project. A basic romance plot with deception, majesty, and attraction. There's extra whimsy though in this natural folky environment, as the village features a fantastical aspect. And I'm not talking about the magic that puts this bush into frame. Brigadoon awakens from the fog for one day every century, building major stakes. Those that live there also cannot leave, otherwise it disappears, making the love between Tommy and Fiona limited and consequential. A great method to include tragedy and suspense. When Tommy inevitably has to decide if he wants to stay with Fiona, he declines. Months later, in a busy environment, he's unhappy, guilted with the choice he made. As Tommy's fiancée is boasting with charisma about gossip, future plans, he is barely paying attention. Each moment, a specific word like hill becomes a trigger point, and we hear Tommy's mind playing the songs of his close relationship with Fiona and the whole of Brigadoon. The morning dew. A personal signification of memories haunting our existence, where everything around us can become an audible blur. There's a loss of focus upon the surroundings since the songs are nostalgic, a yearning for some form of reprisal. Everything isn't washed out, it's still easy to understand words Jane is expressing, but like Tommy, it's hard not to be seduced by such beautiful pastimes and dreams, because those minutes to be reflected were beautiful. The scene is wondrous, executing the feeling of distraction and recollection. Gene Kelly looks out into the distance as if Brigadoon is right in front of him, shrouded by clouded fog. When he's reverted back into reality, his face retracts and forces himself to focus, the same as us watching. But it doesn't take long for Brigadoon to return again. For all that was fantastical, profound, Tommy is sitting here in his grounded reality. The fantasy is no longer equated, and his life is neutral. Tommy goes through deception to yearning, ignorance, a sense of longing, and ending selfishly. In a single instant, he snaps and vaguely reveals that he doesn't want to go through with the marriage. And this would be considered a crowd-pleasing moment. He's gonna go back to Brigadoon and live happily ever after. But who is Jane? We don't really know much, but she's attractive, looks similar to Fiona, extroverted, has a knack for planning and living the 1940s life. Tommy's known her longer than Fiona, and she doesn't know his full story. For all she knows, he wants to take flight for a fling, not love. All of these are key points to address, but it shows that our main protagonist isn't a rich peach of delight. And that's a great thing. Tommy is not in the right. He's been deceptive and secretive to his fiance, and only to this point does he urge for Fiona after months of waiting, only for drunken love to decide his return to Brigadoon. He fell in love with someone for a day, with the knowledge that back home...
Go home with Bonnie.
No, not that home. Jane would be eagerly awaiting him. Regret attacks him like a leech, slowly sucking time away with thoughts of what could have been, knowing he has to wait a century, which would be impossible. So in the Valley of Hope, he books that flight and goes back. It ends exactly how you expect it to. I wanted the movie, as well as the musical production, to conclude either at New York, stuck in a dream, or Tommy heading to Scotland for Brigadoon to be empty, leaving a glimmer that the town could appear. Audiences in the 40s and 50s, even to this day, prefer optimistic storytelling though. And there's always a good sensation to come from happy endings. I mean, I enjoy Singing in the Rain's finale for that merit. If Kathy just left the theatre, the whole film would crumble in its replay value, as it doesn't complement the merry nature we partook in. But Brigadoon has a bigger opportunity, since the scenario and the final scenes weigh in that value of what is important. Was that love of Fiona something to be considered sacred for one moment? A moment so unforgettable it's all you can think about for years, but grow to accept that the real life is here. Maybe in future adaptations we could see this scene play out again, but instead of bombarding music, we see a visual complementing the score. Perhaps how La La Land accomplished the what-if scenario, even the tragic portrayal of what could have been in Mummy. Seeing Tommy and Fiona's love expand from one day to more, but with that dream, I'll be longing for that, the same as Tommy. Till then, Brigadoon will always be there, in memory.